Is everyone here? That's a dumb question, because if you're not here, how would you know you weren't here? Folks, first of all, let me thank the mayor for sticking with me and showing me around. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And, you know, as you just walk around here and look at these few homes, my mother used to have an expression, but for the grace of God, can you imagine this tree falling through your roof in your home? I met the family who lives one door down from, this is used as a church. Had that tree, it's got to be 75, 100 feet long. Had that gone 10 degrees to the right, it would have been through the young woman's bedroom. She would have been gone. So I tell you what, you know, I just did this aerial tour with Live Oak Police Chief Keith Davis, surveying the damage on the way up here and then on the ground since we've been here, surveying the damage of a Category 3 hurricane that made landfall Wednesday morning. No winds this strong had hit this area in 100 years. Pray God it'll be another 100 years before this happens again. Senator Rick Scott, who is with me today, I want to thank him for his cooperation, his help, and he shares the view I do about FEMA. They're doing an incredible job. But the work, in a sense, is just beginning. We got a lot of work to do. And all the officials from Florida, I want to thank them. Jill and I spent time with the incredible first responders and folks who ran toward the danger instead of away from the danger when this storm was coming and when it hit. And with their families, whose lives have been upended. We didn't meet everybody. We met a lot. Here in Live Oak, massive trees, as I was referring, were uprooted from intense hurricane-force winds, flooding and severe damage of homes and businesses. Police Chief Davis, who's probably can hardly wait till I go because we're spending so much time with him today, and I appreciate it. I really do, Chief. He not only, while he was doing his job, he lost part of his house, he lost the roof on his barn. It was destroyed. A leader at school lost part of her roof and her car was destroyed. Power is out across the county as chicken processing plants and lumber mills, so they can't operate, affecting the economic well-being in the near term. Just here in this county, millions of broiler chickens who had to be destroyed. I know a little about that. Delaware and the Delmarva Peninsula is a $4 billion industry. It's the way people make their living. It's the way you feed the world. It's amazing. And hundreds of broken power poles, down power lines, means many of you in Live Oak still have no power. I know it's frustrating and it's hard, and I've directed FEMA to help you in every way they can. And FEMA in the future can fund and replace these wooden poles with steel poles that are much safer and much more resistant to further kinds of storms like this. Families piecing their lives back together, but through it all, you've seen it, and the press has seen it too. Neighbors helping neighbors. I mean, really, generally, neighbors helping neighbors. With determination and optimism. The spirit of this community is remarkable. When people are in real trouble, the most important thing you can give them is hope. And there's no hope like your neighbor walking across the street and see what they can do for you, or the local pastor or someone coming in and offering you help. It gives you hope. And hundreds of dedicated line workers were here restoring power. I asked for an estimation how many line workers from other states came knowing the hurricane was coming. 20 states, including Georgia and Alabama, sent line workers to try to reestablish electric connections here in this state. 20 different states to get this community back. I've been in frequent touch with Governor DeSantis since the storm made landfall. And at my direction, FEMA Administrator Criswell, she traveled to Florida Wednesday night after having been here earlier. And I approved the request within 6 hours of the time the governor sent his ask for a major disaster declaration. At the same time, I request from Governor McMaster of South Carolina for an emergency declaration. That's a fancy way of saying just getting help immediately and all we can do under the law. And folks, we're making federal assistance available for Florida survivors whose homes or businesses are damaged and destroyed. We're helping Florida and South Carolina deliver meals and water and remove debris. And we pre-positioned ahead of time the FEMA pre-positioned, knowing this storm might hit meals and water throughout this area. Before this storm, we pre-deployed 1,500 federal personnel and 900 Coast Guard personnel. That's not to mention the National Guard, the State National Guard that's here that's weighed in as well. We served millions of meals, thousands of tarps, blankets, and cots. And from the moment this storm hit, federal search and rescue teams helped people whose homes were surrounded by water. And now the storm has passed, and you're dealing with what's left in its wake. And we're not going anywhere, the federal government. We're here to help the state as long as it takes. FEMA and the Small Business Administration are here to help residents whose homes and businesses were destroyed or damaged, and you can determine whether you qualify and how to get the help if you haven't been contacted already by going to disasterassistance.gov and register for assistance. If you had any damage, go to disasterassistance.gov to register for assistance. Earlier this week, I visited FEMA headquarters in Washington to thank the emergency responding personnel who are working 24/7 here in Florida and throughout the Southwest, Southeast, and in Maui, in Hawaii. I want to reiterate that appreciation today. I also convened my entire cabinet as part of a whole-of-government response, and that response is to increase the number and intensity of the extreme weather events and be wary we're going to be use all the resources available to the government to do it. Nobody can deny the impact of climate crisis. At least nobody intelligent can deny the impact of the climate crisis anymore. Just look around the nation and the world for that matter. Historic floods, intense droughts, extreme heat, deadly wildfires that have caused serious damage like we've never seen before. Just since being president, in 2.5 years, I've flown over more land burned to the ground as a consequence of wildfires than occupy the entire land of the state of Maryland, from down in New Mexico and Alabama all up into Montana and around. It's been devastating. Folks, when I took office, I directed my team to raise our game in how to lead and coordinate our response to natural disasters. I met people here today that are, and when they need our help the most, is the reason why we've done it. Just look around this community or every other community you've followed me to. Folks, to not only meet people where they are when they need help the most, but to build back stronger and more resilient. Just like I directed my entire cabinet to do in Maui, to help devastated communities recover and rebuild there as it was before. You know, these crises are affecting more and more Americans. And every American rightly expects FEMA to show up when they are needed to help in a disaster. So I'm calling on the United States Congress, Democrats and Republicans, to ensure the funding is there to deal with the immediate crises, as well as our long-term commitments to the safety and security of the American people. I'm here today to deliver a clear message to the people of Florida and throughout the Southeast.